Now there can be certain business questions also with that can be solved by maxima and minima method. Like there can be revenue problems, there can be stock problems, inventory issues that can be solved with the help of maxima minima. Let us see some example. Now this is a business problem in which we have been given this function y is equals to this, and here in the question has been given y stands for total revenue. Now this is our total revenue. X here in the equation means number of units sold. What we have to find out is number of unit that maximize the total revenue. So this is Y. Y is total revenue only that will be maximizing this function. So here we are going to apply the maxima minima method. So first thing you have done, we directly take the derivative. Derivative of 40 lakh will be 0. If you open this bracket with the formula, or we can directly take the derivative. Let us take the derivative. It will be minus 2 will be coming in the front. So it will be x minus 2000 into again derivative of x minus 2000. You can open the bracket also first, then the derivative. It is going to show you the same answer. It will be minus 2x plus 4000 into derivative of x will be 1 minus 0. So it will be 1. So if we do not write this also, it is fine. So this is the derivative we got. Now the second step, you know, maxima minima, we have to keep the value that we got of derivative is equals to 0 so that we can calculate the value of x. So from here x will be minus 4000 divided by minus 2. It will be 4000 by 2, that is 2000. So x is 2000. This is the first answer that we got. Because in the question it has been given that x is number of units sold. So number of unit that will maximize the TR. This is the maximized value. So 2000. It means when 2000 units will be produced, our TR is going to be maximum. So first answer we have got, the answer is 2000. Now second point is amount of maximum revenue. If you want to calculate the amount of maximum revenue, this is the revenue TR. That is why. So we will put this value in this equation of 2000 and we will see what is the maximized total revenue. So it is 40 lakhs. X has come out to be 2000 minus 2000 square. That is going to be, here minus sign is also there. So 4 lakh and 2000 minus 2000 is 0, square will also be 0. So you can say that maximum, second answer, amount of maximum total revenue is 40 lakh only. The third question that has been asked in this point is, what is the total revenue if 2500 units are produced? So if 2500 units means X is number of units. So in that case, our TR will be this 40 lakh minus 2500 will be our X minus 2000 square. So it will be 500 square. That is the 2,50,000. When we will deduct it from 40 lakh, it will be 37,50,000. So this is how business problems also can be solved with the help of maxima minima principle. Let us see another example. This is another question in which C has been given and R has been given. So C means cost. Cost is 100 plus 0.15 x square, and R is the revenue, and revenue is 30x. We have to find out the production rate, that is, we have to calculate the value of x that we can solve with the help of maxima minima that maximizes the profit. So if we see at cost and revenue, you all know the formula for calculating the profit is revenue minus cost. So revenue is 30x minus cost is 100 plus 0.15 x square. So from here we will calculate the profit function. So now moving further, just deducting this function, it will be 30x minus 100 minus 0.15 x square. So this is our y we have got from here. So now what we will do is, according to maxima minima principle, we will have to take the derivative of y with respect. Derivative of 30x will be 30 minus 100, derivative will be 0, no need to write. And derivative of 0.15x square will be 0.3x. Now the next step will be, according to the first method, putting this derivative is equals to 0. It will be 30 minus 0.3x is equals to 0, and we will calculate the value of x from here. So x will be 30 divided by 0.3. So answer will be 100. That is what we was asked in the question x we have to calculate, so answer is 100. This is another business problem related to inventory. So here we have been given the material in demand is 10,000 units per year and the cost of material is rupee 1 per unit. Ordering cost has been given rupees 25 per order. Storage cost, that is also known as carrying cost, is 12.5% of average stock. So first step we have to calculate is the total cost. We know that the total cost is the combination of three costs: material cost, ordering cost and storing cost. So if the regarding the quantity we have not been given anything and we have to calculate the material cost, so first component is the material cost. Material cost is as we require 10,000 units and the cost for one is rupee 1, so material cost will be 10,000. Now second component is the ordering cost. Now ordering cost, for ordering cost we need the number of orders to be placed. In the question, in the first part, number of orders have not been given, so we will assume that it to be equal to Q. So we require, so for calculating the ordering cost we require the number of orders to be placed. In the question, regarding the quantity in one order has nothing been given, so 10,000 units are to be ordered and we do not know at one point how many units can be ordered, so we will keep it to be equal to Q is equal multiplied by 25 because the cost of one order is 25. So the second component's answer we will be writing as 2,50,000 divided by Q. The third type of cost will be the component of total cost is the carrying cost. The formula for calculating the carrying cost, as you all know, is the number of units, that is 10,000 in the question, divided by 10,000 divided by 2. So we are just assuming, Q, assuming that if this quantity is Q into 12.5% into half. So solving this portion, we will be getting 0.125 Q. So these three costs will be added to calculate the total cost under point number 1. Coming to the point number 2, we have to calculate the EOQ and then properly cost will be coming, because in the first point we have to put Q as number of units were not given, but in the second point first we will calculate the number of units, economic order quantity, then its cost will be seen. So let us see what is the value of EOQ. The formula for the calculation of EOQ that is applied in 2CO divided by I. So 2, so consumption, that is our demand here is of 10,000 units, into ordering cost has been given in the question rupees 25, and I is 25 by 2%. So 25 by 200 we can write, or we can replace it with the division. 25 by 200 will be 0.125. Now solving this in the under root, you will get 2000 units. So now this is our EOQ, 2000 units. So from here we will calculate the number of orders to be placed. If in the year 10,000 units have to be ordered and in one order we have to ask for 2000 units, it means we will be putting 5 orders in a year. So now we calculated the EOQ, now we will calculate the total cost according to the EOQ. Again the same three components will be there. First cost is the material cost, that will be 10,000 into 1, material cost will be same, that is 10,000. Second is ordering cost, we just calculated the number of orders were 5 and ordering cost for one order is 25. So 5 into 25 is 125. The third component is carrying cost. For calculating the carrying cost, we apply the formula 10,000 divided 10,000 means material, how much is required, divided by number of orders. In this question, we have 5 orders, into half. Half is for the average inventory, and 12.5, that is 12.5% has been given for the cost. So solving this, we will get 125 only. So the answer for total cost under EOQ is rupees 10,250. Coming to the third part of the question, here we have been given that order of 2500 has to be put. So here we can say that EOQ is 2500. So if EOQ is 2500, so we can say that number of orders to be placed, if 10,000 has to be demanded in a year and 2500 is demanded at one point, number of orders is 4. So I'll just make the changes over here. Material cost will be same, it won't change. Here 4 orders will be placed, so our ordering cost will be 4 into 25, that is 100 rupees. And the last carrying cost 10,000 will be same. Here number of orders will be 4, rest is going to be same. We will get 156.25. So adding these three components, our total cost will be 10256.25. This will be the total cost if 2500 units are ordered. So this is how the various business problems can be solved with the help of maxima and minima.